How's your day today, guys? I hope you're all doing fine. And like most of you, I'm undergoing self-quarantine. So I don't have work. I don't know when I'm gonna get back to work, but I hope that it's all gonna be fine. So today or tonight, this is actually 1:02 in the morning, and I just checked Twitter. I'm not using Facebook because Facebook, for some reason, has an issue with my account. So I like doing Twitter, and this is one of my many Twitter accounts because Twitter kept banning me for posting politically incorrect posts. I don't know what's going on with Twitter, but you know, I'm just checking Twitter right now, and as you can see, while having my self-quarantine, I'm enjoying it. I'm an introvert, so for those introverts out there like me, I think they are enjoying it. It's just gonna be an ordinary day. This is just an ordinary day for them because they love to be alone. They hate crowds. They're not into crowds. It's not that they hate crowds. That's one of the myths about introvert people. They just don't enjoy being in a crowd, and as much as possible, they would like to, you know, be alone and enjoy being alone. So, all right. So the top trends on Twitter today is Chinese virus. I have a problem with this, so let's just recap, okay? I'll be going over this top trends one by one. I've checked what's in this top trends just a few minutes ago. So Namasteng in a way is trending, and it's related to the other trend, Kat Arambulo. I don't know who this person is, but let's just talk about all this, because self-quarantine should the purpose of self-quarantine, let me just clarify, is also to have a peace of mind, okay? For those who can, okay? Because not all people can afford to self-quarantine for a couple of days. And that's what I thought prior to all of this. After President Duterte declared or placed the entire Metro Manila under community quarantine, the very first, you know, declaration he had on, I think that was March 13, okay? I thought, well, a lot of people are gonna get hurt, okay, in terms of their livelihood, their employment, especially those working in the informal sector. Okay, let's be sensitive to these people, because not all are self-employed or employed, okay? Not all can have a vacation for too long. The rich people, the definition of rich is that you can have any indefinite vacation anytime you want. That's the definition of a wealthy individual. Like, for example, the football player, Ronaldo, okay? Ronaldo declared that he's gonna go to his private island when a lot of Italian people are dying, you know, old, vulnerable, medically vulnerable, you know, Italian people are dying of these illness or virus, coronavirus, okay? And I don't know if he declared that he's gonna go to his private island, but that's the report. Probably he just did it privately, and you know, some people in the media got to know about his going to his private island, but I think that's a bit or too insensitive. You know, when people around you are dying, and these are the people who, you know, made you, you know, the superstar that you are, gave you the wealth that you have. All right, so I'm a libertarian, so I'm for wealthy people enjoying their wealth as long as they got their wealth legally or through lawful means. They've never used the government to enrich themselves. They are not corrupt. They didn't steal whatever wealth they have. So I'm for, you know, these people enjoying or using their wealth in order to shield themselves and their family from the virus, okay? I'm all for that. But sometimes we need to be sensitive, okay? Those who have the means should contribute. And that's voluntary. The government should not step in to force these people, the wealthy people, to contribute or to share part of their wealth for the common good. I'm not in favor for that. This should be voluntary, and we need to use our common sense. And that's the reason why I'm doing Twitter right now, to discuss this common sense I'm talking about. So, Chinese virus. The problem with, you know, we are lucky. Like I said in my tweet, this is my Twitter account. This is a new Twitter account. I have zero followers or follower, and I'm just following four Twitter individuals. So I said on this post, okay, let's just talk about this freak out going on in America. They have more problem with President Donald Trump, the very first leader who stepped in and acted against the virus, okay, the very first leader outside of China. And he's been very critical of China for decades. He's been warning Americans about the threat of China, the hegemonic threat, whatever the threat China poses, militarily and economically. He's been warning Americans and American, you know, those behind the curtain, okay, the policy makers, those behind the curtains, for decades, okay. And Americans are lucky to have President Donald Trump, okay. And okay, here's my tweet 11 hours ago. Filipinos are lucky to have no journalists or journals suffering from a Filipino version of Trump derangement syndrome, or what they call their TDS. Why? Because Filipino media are afraid of being shut down. We've heard the case of Rappler, we've heard the case of ABS-CBN being threatened to be shut down via co-warrant too. There's also an ongoing, you know, campaign. Well, probably that's already died out, but an ongoing campaign before to not renew the congressional franchise of ABS-CBN. But of course, that's not gonna happen, because congressmen, the lawmakers, are gonna decide on that. But the minion, okay, the attack boy of President Duterte, the Solicitor General, would like to up his resume, okay, gusto yung magpabango. He'd like to appease his master, so he filed a co-warranto. Co-warranto is being abused in this country already, okay. Co-warranto with this, or before the Supreme Court, to disqualify, you know, whatever the franchise or right given to ABS-CBN. But that's gonna be another story. So going back, they're afraid of being shut down by Duterte. U.S. liberal media seems so happy spreading lies and hysteria about COVID-19 to hurt Trump. In the Philippines, we have the Duterte minions like Panelo peddling fake news. Okay, which is true. Like, you know, you should eat banana in order to fight the virus. I've seen that on Twitter, actually. A lot of fake news going on just a few days ago, when one of probably these people peddling so-called or not really confirmed fake news, is that's the information they got that time, and this is just a brand new virus. So also, Americans were freaking out that President Donald Trump called the virus, what do you call this, Chinese or China virus, when it's the journalists, it's the fake news propagandists from CNN, from MSNBC, from the liberal media, the echo chamber media, who use the term Chinese or Wuhan coronavirus a few days, you know, before Trump used the term Chinese coronavirus or foreign virus. And they were freaking out. These people are more concerned, are more obsessed with Trump than the virus. In fact, they are enjoying. They're enjoying the fact that they have a virus now that is threatening to hurt the American economy and thus hurting Trump's President Donald Trump's chances in 2020. In fact, Bill Maher, a comedian who has this HBO program, I was a fan of Bill Maher a few years ago, except, you know, save his TDS or Trump derangement syndrome virus. He's good when it comes to speaking about, you know, or critiquing the radical Islam, or when it comes to the politically incorrect or politically correct nature of liberals and Democrats in the US. I'm all for that. But Bill Maher once said the Democrats needed a recession in order to beat or defeat Donald Trump in 2020. And this is their own recession. This is their own recession. Okay, so I said here. Okay, I was sending replies. Let me just check. Posted this prior that these people are actually morons, because it was the TDS or Trump haters on CNN who first used the word China virus or Chinese coronavirus or one coronavirus. It's not Donald Trump. So let me just show it to you.
Because you're starting to hear the Republicans, especially Trump, calling it the Wu.
So this is Chris Cuomo, you know, the brother of Andrew Cuomo, the governor of New York, you know, criticizing, trying to attack President Donald Trump for using the word Chinese coronavirus. Okay, he's attacking the Republicans, and the Republican Party is a party of President Donald Trump. So here's this moron, Fredo Cuomo. He's called the Fredo Cuomo. Fredo from the movie Godfather, which is an Italian family. The characters of that movie are Italian mafias. So here we go. And Chris Cuomo is an Italian American.
Because you're starting to hear the Republicans, especially Trump, calling it the Wuhan or the Chinese coronavirus. They're looking for someone to blame.
Concern is growing this morning over an outbreak of a new SARS-like virus in China.
Okay, here are the the morons from CNN. They don't have self-awareness. That's their problem. They were the ones who called it Wuhan or Chinese coronavirus, and I'm going to show it to you.
At least 6 people have died from the Wuhan coronavirus.
The 34-year-old ophthalmologist diagnosed Saturday with the Wuhan coronavirus.
The Wuhan coronavirus. What more can you tell us about the similarities or differences between SARS and the Wuhan coronavirus?
The Wuhan coronavirus
fears continue to grow over the outbreak of the Wuhan coronavirus.
The Wuhan coronavirus. We have new information about how the Wuhan coronavirus is spread.
Tying coronavirus to China and Chinese people isn't just a racist dog whistle. It's a whole racist.
Okay, that's meant to be the moron, one of the most moronic, non-comedians in the United States, actually. So I said earlier today that this is the recession being prayed for by Bill Maher. And Trump said the same to that effect before, and he was criticized for that, for saying that this is the Democrats' new hoax. And, you know, the Democrats and the liberal media, the liberal fake news media, were saying, oh, Trump said that the virus is a hoax. That's not what he said, you morons. That's not what we said. Context matters. Context matters. So we have President Donald Trump still saying he's not budging down. He's not gonna apologize. He's not gonna fold, you know, to these morons, or, you know, these hypocritical, racist, and race-baiting morons. So if you're a Filipino, if you're an Asian, you go to the United States, notice that the most racist are actually the white Democrats and liberals. They're just using racism, politicizing race in order to hurt the other party, in order to dominate again the political spectrum in the US. That's what they're trying to do. These people are psychopaths. This is the technique being used by psychopaths in order to manipulate you. Gaslighting and manipulation. Okay? The what they call emotional blackmail. They're using emotional blackmail in order to get your support, in order to convince you that, hey, I'm your friend. I'm against racism when I'm actually a racist. Okay? These people are racist, actually. President Trump, he's never racist. He's been around with black people, Mike Tyson. A lot of black people like him, including Oprah Winfrey. And now Oprah Winfrey is, like, against him because he ran for president under the Democratic Party banner. So he's calling it the Chinese virus. Earlier today, he called it the China virus, and President Trump doubled down, calling it the Chinese virus, okay? The Chinese virus. And people are freaking out because Trump used that term, Chinese virus. So I saw that earlier. So, killer. And he's calling it now killer virus. But it's actually the liberals, the Democrats, and the fake news media who called it the China or Wuhan coronavirus first. Okay, so Trump said, some are being hit hard by the Chinese virus, which is actually true because according to the timeline collated by experts, the Wuhan coronavirus, I'm using the term now, the Chinese virus hit the United States on January 21st. And the very first carrier of that virus came from Wuhan, China. Wuhan in China. So it's definitely a Wuhan coronavirus. And a lot of viruses were named from their places of origin, like, for example, the MERS-CoV, Middle East something virus, Ebola virus, a lot of this, the Spanish flu, you know. And again, these American liberals are so stupid. They have more problem. They think that Trump is a bigger problem than the virus, when Trump was the very first leader, okay, outside of China, who acted against, or who did the very first action, okay, against the virus, okay, and then every country follows suit. That's when WHO declared the virus to be a pandemic, and that's when President Duterte banned China as well. Travels from China, he did ban travels from China, and then he declared that the entire Metro Manila is going to be on a lockdown, and then after that, the curfew, and after the curfew, the enhanced community quarantine on the 16th or yesterday. And a lot of people were hurt, actually, because of that. So let's go back to the trending. to the trends that we're talking about. So, namasteng in a mo. So, I heard I heard the term namaste when President Trump went to India last month, or I think that was January. The Prime Minister of India greeted Trump by saying namaste, Trump, and the crowd, 50,000 to probably over 60,000 crowds in one of the biggest stadium, probably the biggest, you know, outdoor stadium in Asia, were shouting namaste, Trump, namaste, Trump, namaste, Trump. So this must, the word namaste, because Indians are, they're Hindus, okay? Most of the Indian population are Hindus, and it means the divine in me bows to the divine in you. It's a sign of respect. And this namaste animal is trending. We have this YouTuber. I also do YouTube, so please subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be doing a lot of open rant, as I call it. Or, you know, screenshot vlogging. That's another term. So, he's at this, I think she's a transgender. This lady, just call it lady. I'm going to use the pronoun proper for what this person identifies with, which is a she, okay? She looks like a female. So, she's probably a transgender. I'm not sure. I could be wrong. I'm sorry. I'd apologize in advance. So, hey guys, she said, hey guys, I would just like to apologize for my outburst caused by these privileged influencers. I have a problem with the term influencers. I didn't know it's now a job, you know, a job description or a job category. So let's just click on it. Namaste.
Hey guys, so I would just like to apologize for the outburst that I'm about to have, because ang tanga-tanga mo rin eh, no? Akala mo rin napatunayan ka sa pinagkagagawa mong hayop ka. Hayop ka, nakainis ka, nangigigil ako sa putang ina mo rin eh, no? Alam mo bang hayop ka? Ang napatunayan mo lang, isa ka malaking ignorating mata pobre, tanga. Alam mo ba't ginagawa ng mga Pilipino at bakit sila nagkatrabaho pa rin, ha? Kasi hindi naman sila kasing yaman mo eh, para magkaroon ng pera at pribilehyo yung manahimik sa kanilang bahay at murah-murahin ang kanilang kapwa, ha? Tang ina mo, edi ikaw na nakaligo, ikaw na naka-Netflix, hayop ka, ang tanga-tanga mo rin eh, no? Sa kakayoga mong hayop ka, yung utak mo, napunta na sa pwet mo, namasteng ina mo, sana narahimik ka lang, hindi sa'yo, umiikot ang mundo, putang ina ka nang... Hey, guys.
So, that's it. So, I don't know if the person being referred to by this YouTuber has deleted the post, but her name is trending. I don't freaking know who this person is, this cat Arambulo, but she seems like a socialista, or I don't know. What I gather from that profanity filled Twitter rant is this lady was probably bashing, and she probably went on a profanity-laced online outburst on Instagram, bashing Filipinos na pasaway, who still would like to work despite, you know, President Duterte's lockdown or curfew. I don't know. So let's just listen.
Was directed to people who aren't listening. So I please, so I'm really, really sorry.
This is the explanation. Posted by this cat Arambulo. So she's now like trying to explain away her outburst, okay? That's what she's trying to do in this clip.
I'm really, really sorry to have to take it out on social media, but like that outburst was a reflection of how I really feel about people not listening to the government. At this point in time, like honestly, people really...
Well, we listen as much as possible. You know, I'm a government skeptic. I as much as possible, I'm not into big government And there are probably some better ways to address this coronavirus issue or this Chinese Wuhan coronavirus issue. But government all over the world are acting, you know, doing these draconian measures to address the matter in order to contain the virus. So I'm giving, like I said in one of my previous vlogs, I'm giving the government the benefit of the doubt. But to bash people, to curse people, to bash them for still trying their best to work, because these people are not privileged enough to have a 1 month vacation or a 1 week vacation. They need to, their pay, you know, living from paychecks to paychecks, you know, that's totally inappropriate. Okay, and of course the police are being used to address the matter as well, to probably arrest people who are pasaway, who are not following the rules. That's their job as well. But to bash these sectors of our society just because, you know, these are the worst hit, okay, sector of people. There are some people, like I said, probably millions, because, you know, we are not America. Even people in America are being hurt, okay? Economists are fearing that the coronavirus is going to cause the loss of millions of jobs when President Trump just recovered all these manufacturing jobs in just 2 years, and that's all gonna go down the drain, okay? So we are a third world country. Millions of people are gonna get hurt, okay? So it's like sacrificing, we are being hurt as well. So I work, I don't know when we're gonna get back to work. We're just waiting for the announcement coming from my company, okay? And what my company did is that they released our salary earlier than the usual. So good job for my company for doing that. And probably they're gonna release half or probably the whole of our 13th month pay. I don't know, because we don't know when this, you know, this lockdown is gonna last. According to the government or the president may suspend it if needed, or if it's already necessary, or extend the lockdown. And the president, to his credit, I'm not a Duterte fan. I'm very critical of him, actually. The president, to his credit, encouraged the private sector to help out by probably releasing the 13th month pay early, or probably half of it. So I somehow gather from that speech that it's gonna last on the scheduled date, April 14. Or it could be earlier, based on that statement. So this lady, well, maraming pabibo ngayon, you know, maraming pabibo, not being rational enough, not being able to weigh, you know, things down the way we should weigh things out. And okay, let's just continue with the whole
lockdown and contain the virus. I'm not saying and referring to the frontliners out there that need to get to work, but what I'm saying is the people that are pasaway and not following. I mean, honestly, everyone's affected.
The people are, the people that this lady is describing as pasaway and not following, they don't have any choice at all. Okay, we are actually hitting their livelihood by staying home. And most of these people are working for, and we don't even know where are they working for. They're probably working for the necessary, the essential sectors of our society. These are probably the people who are answering our questions whenever we call the hotline. These are the very people who are probably delivering goods to, I don't know, we don't know. These are probably working, you know, in essential industries and helping us out. And for us to judge them, for us to bash them, for us to curse them, that's totally inappropriate. These are people, they're not probably working for themselves and their family. They're probably helping out there. They're, you know, the invisible heroes out there. And bawal maging judgmental, okay? Sa panahon ngayon, we need to use restraint. These are probably, these people, these Pasaway people who are not following the rules are probably working in the food industry, in the service industry, and they're trying to help out alleviate. They are the Atlas of today. They are making our society go round. Okay, while us who can stay at home, can stay home. Okay, that's my speculation, because all we have is a speculation. We don't have the facts. And I've seen these people on, let me just show it to you, on YouTube. They're fighting against the government. And not really fighting in terms of political struggle, but they're fighting for their family. We need to go home. We just came from work. Okay, when I saw the video, I thought we're for social distancing, but when I saw the video, okay, this is one of the videos I've seen on. The ads. Okay. This was actually a video yesterday.
Mga residenteng naharang sa boundary ng Caloocan at San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. At live mula sa San Jose del Monte, Bulacan, may unang balita si Darlene Kai. Darlene.
Ivan, sa mga oras na ito ay marami pa rin stranded dito sa boundary ng Caloocan at San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. Pero ngayon lamang nag-anunsyo yung mga polis na nagbabantay dito na bukod sa mga uniformed personnel at mga health workers ay pinapapasok na rin yung mga empleyado ng BPO sa mga call centers, mga grocery.
Okay, so call center, grocery, well,
right now, and the only way,
let's just continue with that video.
Groceries o supermarkets, sa mga nagtitinda sa mga palengke at yung mga nagtatrabaho sa mga bangko at iba pang mga nagbibigay ng pangunahing serbisyo at pangangailangan. Mula kasi hating gabi kanina ay naghigpit.
Okay, so they are working in the primary service industries. Let's just say call center, but these people are answering phone calls. We don't know where they're working for probably, but these are working for essential industries. And if this lady is gonna lose her internet, she's probably gonna be freaking out, and she's gonna be calling her internet provider, PLDT or other, you know, competing telecommunication companies. She's probably be freaking out, cursing at the agent on the other line, you know, shouting profanities. I don't know. So we need to have some parts of our industries, essential industries, going. They need to continue operating for people like us who can stay at home, stay home. All right, that's the only explanation we have. And again, like I said, bawal maging judgmental. And I hope this is not gonna, this lockdown and curfew is not gonna be extended. So what they're trying to do, the government's trying to do, not just this government, but governments all over the world, is to contain or isolate. We are isolating, we are trying to self-quarantine in order to isolate the virus. Find the virus where it may be, and then isolate the people who carry the virus. That's a strategy, okay? So that it's not going to be spread out, because, you know, the government doesn't have the capability to address, you know, a widespread, you know, the worst case scenarios, if tens of thousands of individuals are gonna get infected, according to Nancy Binay's, I'm not pronouncing it, Nancy Binay was actually quizzing health officials in the Senate, and 2,000 beds. We have like, not 2,000 beds, but test kits. Okay, we just have, I don't know the exact figure, but we only have a few thousand test kits. Okay, and we only have a few thousand hospital beds in Metro Manila. So the government is totally incapable or handicapped to address, you know, a real pandemic in Metro Manila. And apart from that, the government cut, okay, the budget for, I think, infection surveillance by 10 billion pesos. Okay, that could have helped alleviate the matter or this crisis. So what the government is trying to do is isolate the virus and attack the virus where they find it. Okay, they may find it. And in order to arrest or prevent its spread. Okay, so, and I think the best strategy that we can do is, because according to experts, the virus hit the old people, 60 and above to 80, those are the most vulnerable to this virus, and including the medically compromised, the immunocompromised and medically vulnerable as well. So instead of using, probably after the 14-day quarantine period across Metro Manila, instead of using draconian measure against the healthy population in Metro Manila, we can probably use draconian measure against or for all people, isolate them, okay, and contain them. The medically vulnerable as well should be isolated. I don't know, you know, I'm not an expert. Probably one of the suggestions being made in the US is, because America can afford it, is isolate the medically vulnerable and the old people in hotels. Okay, that's how rich they are, so they can afford it. In our cases, that's something that they need to think about. Okay, but okay, we are it's gonna be about summer humidity, we're feeling it right now. So flu is, well, this is not a flu, but I'm just likening it to a flu. So flu is a seasonal, you know, virus. Okay, it's a seasonal virus. So and in fact, flu is more deadly than the corona, the Chinese coronavirus. It has more or less 3% fatality rate. So it's very contagious. That's the alarming fact about this virus. But good thing is, it's not that fatal compared to pneumonia, which is one of the symptoms of the virus, or compared to other illnesses like flu. So that's a good thing about it. So the healthy people can survive the virus. The most vulnerable are the old people and the immunocompromised population. In fact, even a basketball player was infected. Tom Hanks was infected, so it does not discriminate. So I don't know what's going on Twitter. We should be isolating ourselves, so why the heck we have all this? And then there's another trending going on, which is a scandal. I don't know if the name is Via Gonzalez earlier, but it's no longer trending, and this lady is just 16 years old. I haven't seen the video yet, but it was trending earlier as well. So, I mean, these are some of the lapses in judgment that young people may commit. So let's just let that fly. I'm not interested at all. So here we go. That's my rant. I think I've eaten too much of your time. So if you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe as well. All right. So namaste to all of you. Namasteng in the mode to all those bashers out there who just couldn't use their common sense. If you don't have common sense, sell it. Lazada is still available, I think. Or if you don't use Lazada, just use Facebook Marketplace and use Lalamove to help people working out there. There are still people, the people who you're bashing, okay, are willing to deliver your goods from one place to another, and these are essential parts of our industry, of the industry, the delivery industry. But do not as much as possible, buy outside as long as you trust, you know, the seller. I don't cook. I usually buy my food outside to help the turo, not really turo, but just a small eatery. I've shown that in my previous vlog, by the way, when I went outside at 12 in the evening, Pasaway din ako, no? To buy my food. So as much as possible, still buy if you can afford it. But one tip that I can, in order to help other people, okay, to keep the economy rolling, to keep the economy still working, okay. One tip that I would like to share is do not spend lots of your money during this, you know, community quarantine, because we don't know what's gonna happen next, okay? Your company might decide to shut down, or it may extend, you know, the government may extend the lockdown or the curfew, and your company might not be willing to release half of your 13th month pay, or it might not have programs to help address financial crisis or critical wallet day. So be wise when spending your money. I'm trying to. I hope I can, but that's going to be a challenge for me. And this is Gentosum, and have a good one to all of you.